thank you for watching This Week in Hollywood on Sohu.
一周大咖面对面，故人老友喜相逢。老爷，你这是喜脉啊！本期专访时间，一周特派员 Emily 去到了洛杉矶的蒙太奇酒店，和我们的老朋友另一位 Emily 绿箭侠 IT 娘 Emily Bett Rickards 进行了建设性会晤。想知道 Felicity 当上霸道女总裁后丰富的内心活动吗？想知道绿箭侠第四季接下来的走向吗？马上进入专访，听 Emily 亲口跟你讲。
观众朋友们好，我是 Emily， 我们最喜欢的 IT 女又回到了我们节目，欢迎 Emily Bett Rickards。
Yes, yes, yes.
Yeah, it's so good to have you back.
Thank you. I'm glad to be here.
Season 4 has been filled with a lot of drama so far.
Surprise.
Yeah. How do you like being CEO?
I do like it. I think Felicity likes it a lot because she's good at it.
What other changes will we see Felicity going through this season?
Well, she's in this deep relationship, so I think there's just going to be changes with that.
And your character also has a new partner in crime now, Mr. Terrific.
Oh, yeah.
I love the fact that you guys are buddies.
Oh, he's so great. I mean, I wonder if he'll end up joining our team. I feel like there's a very good possibility that he could because he works so closely with Felicity and everybody loves working with Echo. So there's no reason for that not to happen. But I don't know, like what else could happen? Like what else could be his future?
A lot of fans were hoping that, you know, you could be like a superhero and he could be the new Felicity.
Oh, that would be so cool. Well, yeah. I feel like Felicity, I mean, in my mind, Felicity's already a hero.
Absolutely.
But in her mind, I think a lot of the time she's like, well, am I really a hero? I know this is what I wanted to do.
Do I have a code name?
Do I have a code name?
All right, superhero. Well, tell us about this new enemy, Damian Dark.
He's scary as hell.
Yeah.
He's got this mystical magic. He's a huge threat. I mean, he's trying to take over a city and he's doing a good job of it. And Team Arrow is just trying to do the best they can to sort of eliminate this threat so that they can save their city, but at the same time, there's only so many of them.
And can you comment on Nissa and Ra's al Ghul's roles in this upcoming season?
I feel like they still carry so much weight in our story that they can't be forgotten or pushed aside, so that the story and Starling City in the view of through the eyes of Team Arrow is always holding on to them. So
Gotcha. The
weight of them is always there and imminent and can be instant.
What about crossovers with Arrow?
Oh yeah, it's happening. We have, you know, all these characters from The Flash and introducing new characters from Legends and, you know, getting to work with different characters is always such a dream.
Do you miss Colton?
Yeah, I was with him last night.
Oh,
so I don't miss him too much. I miss him a lot at work.
Because I remember when he was still on the show, you guys would take photos together all the time and it just seems like he was like your buddy on set. For Halloween, which wasn't too long ago, his Ursula costume was pretty on point, and you were Sailor Moon.
That has been a dream of mine since I was like 5.
Sailor Moon was like the first superhero point of contact for most Asian girls growing up.
And it holds up.
Yeah.
It's still good.
Well, you've been pretty busy outside of Arrow too, and you recently filmed Brooklyn.
Yes.
So tell us about that.
So Brooklyn has just recently hit theaters. It's a movie in three parts. It was based on a novel. It's a beautiful story about a woman played by Saoirse who is trying to find her identity and start a new life in America in 1952. And she comes over from Ireland and just beautifully directed and beautifully shot and beautifully written, and I just think it's a beautiful story.
Well, right now you're currently shooting in Vancouver for Arrow. When you're in Canada and you're filming there, what do you miss most about LA?
Well, I have my friends here too, so probably them.
And finally, if the Chinese fans came to LA, where would you recommend them to go to?
Well, I love the hikes here. I love hiking. Runyon Canyon, the Hollywood sign, Griffith Park, it's all beautiful. There's batting cages in the valley. And when the Hollywood Forever Cemetery is on, there's movies in the park. I think that's always really fun.
Okay, fan questions. Ni Lasin Ming Xiao asked, if Arrow and Flash were to fight over you, whose side would you be on?
Well, probably Oliver's. Me or Felicity? Felicity would be on Oliver's.
Felicity would be on Oliver's. Jing Guo asked, what are some of the other characters you would like to take on in the future?
I kind of want to do comedy. I like to see people in ridiculous situations.
Nothing Compares You asked, do you want to come to China and meet all your Chinese fans?
Sure.
If so, what city would you like to visit?
I've never been to Hong Kong. Like, I want to go watch everyone on the street and like be like, what's that? Like, what's new over here?
All right, lightning round with Emily Bett Rickards. What app do you use the most?
Fancy, it's a shopping app or Twitter.
And what is your favorite staycation activity?
Massages.
What is your least favorite food?
That really smelly fruit they have in Thailand that's all spiky.
Oh, the durian!
Yeah, those things should just go away.
One word to describe your character.
Big heart.
What is your favorite romantic activity in LA?
Probably hiking.
And what is your favorite exercise?
Boxing.
And what is your favorite item of clothing on a man?
Just a t-shirt, just a white t-shirt.
White t-shirt, no pants.
No pants, no pants. White t-shirt. Even just like a pair of briefs and a white t-shirt, I'm just like, oh my God.
And your favorite band?
The Dudes, they're a Canadian band.
And final question, if you switch body with any animal in the world for a day, what would it be?
It would be my dog, because I just want to know what she's thinking all the time. She's just like staring at me. I'm like, how are you happy? You're just, can I make you happier? She's like, don't.
Don't.
I know. Don't.
听 Emily 聊完 DC 家的绿箭侠，我们接着看本周新鲜。